Welcome to an introduction to the derivative. The goal of this video will be to define the definition of the derivative. I'd like to start by taking a look at a secant line. The black line above is a secant line. A secant line is a linear approximation of a function between two points on the function. The slope of a secant line represents the average rate of change of the function between two points. Let's take a look at some additional secant lines. In this sketch, the dark blue line is a secant line, and you can see as I move one of the points, the secant line also changes. This secant line represents the average rate of change of the function between these two points. Hopefully this gives you a better feel for what a secant line is. Let's take a look at a real-life example involving a secant line and its applications. Let's say you take a trip from Phoenix, Arizona to Los Angeles, California. You travel 380 miles in 5.5 hours. What would your average speed be? We know that distance is equal to rate times time. If we solve this equation for r, we would have r equals d divided by t. Therefore, we would have 380 miles divided by 5.5 hours, giving us an average speed of approximately 69.1 miles per hour. A graph comparing your time to distance traveled might look something like this. Did you go 69 miles per hour the entire trip? We can see from this graph that we didn't. Looking at the start of your trip, you can see that the change in miles with respect to time is not as large in this region as it is in this region. This may represent when you leave your home traveling to the freeway. Then as you enter the freeway, your rate of change will increase. This middle interval here, we can see that time is passing, but distance is not changing. This may represent a time where you stop for gas or lunch or something. Then again, you enter the freeway, your rate of speed increases. And then as you get closer and closer to LA, maybe you hit traffic and you turn off the freeway, you slow down and reach your destination. If I was to construct a line between the starting point and the ending point, that would be a secant line that would look as follows. The slope of the red line represents the average rate of change, or in this case, the average speed. Now we know from algebra, in order to find the slope of a line, we need to calculate y2 minus 1 divided by x2 minus x1. Let's go ahead and do this. y2 minus y1 would be 380 minus 0 divided by 5.5 minus 0, which of course is the same quotient we had before to find the rate of speed. And this again was approximately 69.1 miles per hour. Again, this would be the average rate of speed for our entire trip. However, the secant line is not really our goal in this situation. Our goal is to find something called a tangent line. A tangent line to a curve is a line that just touches a curve at a single point. You can also think of the tangent line as a linear approximation to a curve at a given point. The slope of a tangent line represents the instantaneous rate of change of the function at a given point. Let's take a look at some additional tangent lines before we go on. Here, the red line is tangent to the curve, and as I move the point of tangency, or the point where the tangent line touches the function, you can see that the tangent line obviously changes as well. Let's take a look at another function. Here we have a cubic function. Again, the red line is the tangent line. You can almost think of this as if you were driving a car on the function. You had a laser beam on the front and back of the car. That laser beam would be the tangent line. Let's take a look at one more. Again, the red line is the tangent line, and as we move the point of tangency, the tangent line will obviously change. Now, the important part here is the slope of this tangent line will represent the instantaneous rate of change of the function at that single point. So if we go back to the graph of our trip to Los Angeles, if we found the point of tangency, let's say right here, and it looks something like this, and let's just say it was parallel to the secant line. We know the slope of the secant line is approximately 69, so this would have the same slope, but what this tells us is that we're going 69 miles per hour at this instant in time. If I found the slope of the tangent line here, let's say, again, that would tell me exactly how fast I was going at that instant in time. It has a lot more power than finding just the average speed for the entire trip. So the real question becomes, how can we find the slope of a tangent line if we only know one point on that line? Let's start by finding the slope of a secant line and see if we can devise a method to find the slope of a tangent line. So let's use this graph and find the slope using these two points. Point one will be x, f of x, and our second point, the x coordinate will be x plus delta x, and the y coordinate will be f of x plus delta x. Now if we take a look at the x-axis for a moment, notice how this first x coordinate is x, and the second one is x plus delta x. So this distance in red would be the change in x, or delta x. This will be an important point. Now if we go ahead and apply the formula from before for slope, m equals y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1, using these two given points, we would calculate the slope of a secant line as follows here. Here's our y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. If we take a look at the denominator for a moment, notice how we have an x here minus x, therefore our denominator simplifies to delta x. This is called the difference quotient. Now in order to find the slope of the tangent line, we need to modify this somehow. If I was to move this point closer to the other point, the slope of the new line would approach the slope of the tangent line. Let's take a look at this with an animation. Again, here's a function with a tangent line. Here's the slope of the secant line. If I take this point and move it closer to the other point, we can see the value of delta x in red is decreasing, and in fact, it is approaching zero. You can also see the slope of the secant line is approaching some value. So essentially what's going to happen here, as delta x approaches zero, the slope of the secant line will approach the slope of the tangent line. Let's take a look at that again. We have our secant line. As delta x approaches zero, the slope of the secant line approaches the slope of the tangent line. So essentially what we have found, that the slope of the tangent line would be equal to the limit as delta x approaches zero of f of x plus delta x minus f of x divided by delta x. Let's go ahead and look at a definition now.
Y prime.
The definition of derivative. For a function y equals f of x, its derivative at x is the function f prime of x, denoted by the limit as delta x approaches zero of this difference quotient, provided the limit exists. If f prime exists, or the derivative of f of x, then we say that f is differentiable at x. The process of finding the derivative of a function is called differentiation. In addition to f prime of x, other notations are used to denote the derivative of y equals f of x. The most common are, again, f prime of x, dy dx, the derivative of f of x with respect to x, and so on. The notation dy dx is read as the derivative of y with respect to x, and this is called Leibniz notation. The next video, entitled Finding Derivatives Using the Limit Definition, will contain some examples of how we can find the derivative of various functions using the definition of derivative. Fortunately, there are many shortcut formulas to finding the derivatives of functions. However, the results of the shortcut formulas we will use very soon are the result of proofs using the limit definition. I hope that helps explain the definition of derivative. Thank you, and have a wonderful day.